Gigabyte makes a lot of rack servers. Hi there, Doug Simon with IT Creations with another rack server from Gigabyte, the R272-Z30 server. At 2U, this platform features 12 3.5-inch storage bays up front with room for two more in back. There's already a revision on this system, which takes it from just supporting first and second generation AMD EPYC series processors in Rev 100 to now supporting third generation EPYCs in Rev A00, including those third generation CPUs featuring AMD 3D V-Cache technology, MILAN X. This is a single socket platform, and this system will max out at 4 terabytes of memory, at least for second and third generation processors. The Gigabyte R272-Z30 server is a second-generation AMD system, as indicated by the numeral 2 on the end of the name. Directly out of the factory, it supports first and second with Rev 100 and Rev A00, or second and third generation CPUs with Rev A00 and Rev B00. There is some overlap. When this system was first released, it only supported first generation and second generation processors. And now it supports third generation CPUs, which is kind of impressive, as most of the platforms I've seen either support first and second generation CPUs or second and third generation CPUs, not the entire EPYC family, or at least not without some other adjustments to the motherboard. I've been assured by Gigabyte that all of these second generation motherboards can also support not only MILAN, but MILAN X CPUs too, as long as it has the latest BIOS. But I digress. For a quick refresher on the most basic differences between Intel and AMD, AMD EPYCs have a system on a chip design with the chipset loaded into the CPU architecture. Intel Xeon scalable processors have the chipset scattered around the system board. Let's leave it at that for now, as this is an EPYC system. The front 12 storage bays can be outfitted with SAS or SATA hot swappable storage devices, with 4 powered by onboard SATA ports and the other 8 connected via the optional SAS HBA. More on that a bit later. There are actually 2 other very similar chassis configurations in this family, the Z31 with 24 2.5-inch SAS SATA storage bays and the Z32 with 24 2.5-inch NVMe SSD bays. A small control panel on the left includes a reset button, non-maskable interrupt button, on-off button, and system ID button. Below those, a few LEDs for HDD status, system status, and LAN 1 and LAN 2 status. The right server ear has a few USB ports for connecting a crash cart for system diagnostics and status. Looking for a network server? This Gigabyte R272-Z30 server might just do the trick. Use that link to visit IT Creations and submit 3 letters of recommendation, a CV, and a purchase history for consideration. I'm kidding. We'll sell these to anybody. Not only that, but you can save up to $500 off the list price of a system that you configure on itcreations.com that's valued at $5,000 or more. Just click that link to see more information. And who knows, maybe you'll be the proud owner of a brand new Gigabyte R272-Z30 server. Your friends are going to be so jealous. On the back of the system, there are dual redundant 800 watt Platinum Plus PSUs on the left, right next to a 2.5-inch drive cage that can support 2 SAS or SATA drives and can be used to support the operating system. Next to those, a VGA port and a serial port. That removable panel at the bottom of the chassis is for an optional Ocp 2.0 mezzanine card with a rear ID button and LED button squeezed in between 2 USB 3.0 ports with a dedicated management port stacked on top. Gigabit Ethernet LAN ports 1 and 2 are next, and another USB 3.0 port and the cover panels for PCI slots 1 through 7. The Gigabyte Management Console provides a user-friendly graphical interface for management and maintenance of a single server and comes pre-installed on the system. Right out of the box, you get real-time health monitoring and management with support for IPMI 2.0, automatic event recording, and monitor and control of Broadcom Mega RAID controllers to more effectively manage your storage. Gigabyte also has the Gigabyte Server Management, or GSM, which is designed to manage multiple servers or clusters of servers over the internet simultaneously. This one actually leverages the Gigabyte Management Console, but provides additional functionality and a suite of other software programs and resources like GSM command line interface, the GSM agent, which you will need on each of the servers to retrieve any kind of useful information, plus a GSM mobile application and a plugin to interface with VMware vCenter. After we remove the cover, you can see the single processor socket with 8 DIMM slots to either side. Memory supported on this system includes registered and load reduced DIMM modules. At full capacity, using 256 gigabyte 3DS RDIMM or LRDIMM memory modules in all slots will result in a little over 4 terabytes of memory. Standard RDIMM or LRDIMM memory modules will provide half of that at up to 2 terabytes of memory. Keep in mind there are three generations of AMD EPYC supported on this system, and those figures I just provided are specifically for the third generation AMD EPYCs and the latest revision A00. Memory speeds of up to 3200 megahertz are supported using third generation processors, or up to 2933 megahertz using second generation CPUs. I'm going to add an abbreviated refresher on EPYC CPUs. First generation CPUs have 32 cores max and a top memory count of 2 terabytes. Second generation CPUs can support up to 4 terabytes of memory and a top core count of up to 64 cores. Lastly, third generation EPYCs can also have 8 to 64 cores and a top memory capacity of up to 4 terabytes. All have improved computational performance from one generation to the next, aside from the core counts and memory support we just went through. The architecture in general also went from Zen 1 to Zen 2, and now the latest manifestation, Zen 3. Zen 3 made improvements to the chiplet design of the cores for better core-to-core communications while reducing latency. But enough of that. This system is designed for general networking applications, like use as a virtual server, file access via VPN, general storage, and use as a shared internet connection, to name a few. Your basic bread-and-butter server applications. The first revision 100 only supported first and second generation EPYCs, and as a result, somewhat less performance. Or in other words, about 2 terabytes of memory using the first generation processors, but 4 terabytes using second gen. Even with support for 4 terabytes of memory, second gen processors have been bested by a 19% performance gain with a third generation chiplet changes, among other things. I should mention that both Rome 2nd and Milan 3rd generation respectively have 256 megabytes of L3 cache, but both are kicked out the door by Milan X processors. Milan X EPYC is available in 4 different SKUs and feature 3D vCache technology and 768 megabytes L3 cache, or 3 times the cache on the standard Milan CPUs. I am really getting a little sidetracked today. The default storage configuration includes 4 SATA drives with 8 SAS drives, assuming you go with the optional SAS host bus adapter. Those 2 2.5-inch drives in back can also be supported natively by default. 4 large hot swap fans just behind the SAS SATA backplane provide cooling for the single CPU, memory modules, and whatever else you decide to install on those PCI slots. Not to mention the optional M.2 drives that you can pop in those x4 PCI 3.0 slots on the motherboard, dedicated for just that task. Those M.2 drives can be used to support the operating system in a RAID, ensuring your system boots and runs even if one of them goes down, like permanently. Of course, you could also use the 2 2.5-inch drives in back for the OS2, but with the NVMe M.2 drives, this system will boot much faster than what those SAS, or if you choose SATA drives, will do. Along with the 2 1 gigabit Ethernet LAN ports on the back, there is also the optional Ocp card offering additional network ports and connection speeds. That is assuming you don't load a network card into one of the 6 PCI slots. I will mention that most of the slots are PCI 4.0, offering twice the speed compared to PCI 3.0. PCI 4.0 also provides excellent throughput for I/O and NVMe storage devices, but no need to really worry about NVMe unless you're interested in the close sibling to this unit, the R272-Z32 with 24 NVMe drives. The Gigabyte R272-Z30 server fits nicely in with the rest of Gigabyte's expanding catalog of rack servers. It offers reliability and adaptability for a wide range of common networking applications. I'm also quite grateful for the fairly limited alphanumeric naming convention. 7 or 8 characters, that seems reasonable. If you're in the market for an enterprise networking server from Gigabyte, or even a GPU server or high-performance computing server designed for AI and AI training, or even cryptocurrency mining, well, the bottom has kind of dropped out of that venture. Check out IT Creations. Until next time, I'm Doug Steuben with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.